There is nothing called darkness, it's just the absence of light. There is nothing called problem, it's just the absence of an idea to find a solution. May I invite Dr. Ramesha, Professor DLIC, Bangalore University, who is one such individual who has gracefully consented to present the conference report today.
Most respected dignitaries on the dais, my teachers and mentors, Professor Eva Yasundi, Dr. T.D. Kemparaj, learned professional experts, my dear professional comrades, very good afternoon to you all. Indeed, it's my great pleasure and privilege to stand before you to present the 2 days national conference report on trends in management of academic libraries in digital environment. Dear colleagues, the network digital environment has brought about a change in the concept of collection of the modern library. Today's libraries are termed electronic, digital, hybrid, virtual libraries throughout the world. More so in country like India, we find a lot of hybrid libraries with a combination of traditional libraries as well as the modern digital libraries. Looking at these changes, this conference has envisioned to conducting bring all the allied professionals in under one umbrella to discuss and deliberate with a contemporary issue, particularly the information and knowledge management in digital library environment. The organizers has thought of an idea of organizing this national event and requested the Jain University. There, graciously, they agreed to host this conference in the prestigious university like Jain University. On behalf of all the delegates and my own personal behalf and all the organized committee, we are very much indebted and thankful to the authorities of the Jain University hosting this conference for the benefit of LIS professional throughout the country and given us an opportunity as a platform to share and deliberate and discuss the various issues involved, particularly with a tune of emerging and innovative cutting-edge technologies with positive impact and influencing on our modern library activities and functions. Friends, the 2 day national conference inauguration function was held on 19th December 2014 at 10 a.m. in the conference hall of Jain University, Jainagar campus, Bangalore. It started with a prayer invoking a blessing of Goddess Sarada with a melodious rendered by Ms. Ananya and Ms. Madhuri Srinivasan. Ms. Jessie Thomas, faculty of Jain University, welcomed the chief guests, dignitaries, invited speakers and all the learned delegates from different parts of India. Dr. M. Krishnamurthy, the conference director, has briefed the theme of the conference and also sub-theme of the conference in a more befitting manner how this conference deliberation will going to take place in the 2 days. The conference was inaugurated by lighting the sacred lamp by the dignitaries on the dais. The chief guest of the function, Dr. Professor V.G. Talwar, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Rewa University and the former Vice Chancellor of University of Mysore, was the chief guest of the inaugural function. The Professor Talwar has congratulated the organizers on the conference theme, the library, Jain University management, for sponsoring and hosting this national conference. He opened his address with a mentioning of OCLC report that is published in 2010. He highlighted the growth and decline in the use of traditional and digital library as the change in the utilization of the library. He has recalled the phylos of library science of the father of library science, Dr. Ranganathan. More particularly, Ranganathan has emphasized more about the concentrating on user satisfaction. The user satisfaction is the ultimate aim of any kind of a library, either it may be a school library or a national library. That's what he thought of an idea, whether it is a traditional library or a digital library, whatever the environment we have, we need to satisfy the user with the utmost scale. And he has emphasized that the advances in technology, particularly the emerging worldwide technology and internet technologies, has very big challenges before the library professional, particularly in the Google generation. Finally, he was concluded with identifying five important key aspects, that is content licensing, metadata standards, e-resource linking, technology advancement, and integration of the network with a user-centric approach. Dr. N.G.R. Iyengar, the pro-chancellor of Jain University, he said that traditional systems are gradually making way of the new technology based on the system in all sectors, including libraries. As a result of growth of number of colleges in the country, the size of the students and other library stakeholders is also increasing with a growing demand of information. In the coming years, the electronic information will be changed the situation, and this change management in the new environment should be studied thoroughly. Professor T.D. Kemparaju, the professor, director and director of distance education, Bangalore University, Bangalore, has delivered the thought-provoking keynote address. Professor Kemparaju opened his address stating that we have to look back to go ahead forward. He traced the number of conferences organized or held in different parts of the country through the years, and he has questioned us, what are the outcome of these conferences? He also highlighted that we are giving too much attention given in this respect of the topic by quoting Dr. M.S. Sridhar, where he was written a very beautiful article in Desi Talk Bulletin. Professor Kemparaju has stressed on the multi-level collaboration attitude by sharing the library sectors. More and more digitization would be lead to providing wider and deeper access to the resources. Dr. Sundarajan, the Vice Chancellor of this prestigious university, has delivered the presidential speech. He said, libraries are turning into the learning resource center. So in this context, it is find out what are the requirements of users. It is found that library services at Jain University is well utilized by the user community. We have proposed, he has proposed the link for all the five locations of the Jain University campus to better resourcing and exchanging information between and among the Jain University campus libraries. The inaugural function concluded with expression of gratitude and vote of thanks by Mrs. N. Miramani, the organizing secretary and librarian of this campus. The inaugural function proceedings were wonderfully coordinated and handled by Ms. Madhavi. Now also she is coordinating wonderfully of valedictory functions also. As per the participation, the conference attracted large number of participants from different parts of India. There are all 150 participants are part of this national conference. Besides this registered participant, the organizing committee has invited good number of distinguished professional experts from different parts of India to share their professional knowledge and experience for the benefit of the LIS community. Coming to the technical session, the conference was divided into five technical sessions. As already mentioned, totally 78 papers are listed in the presentation by the respective authors, out of which 52 papers are presented by the respective author. It leaves that 65% of the papers has been presented for discussion and deliberation. It's a quite encouraging and motivation for the organizing committee. The first technical session was chaired by Dr. R. Ramrajaras, the university librarian, Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, Bangalore. A reporter for this technical session is Ms. V. N. Emavati, assistant professor, Department of Library and Information Science, Tumkur University, Tumkur. An insightful invited session was started by Professor Eva Asundi, the former professor and the chairman, Department of Library and Information Science, Bangalore University, Bangalore. As an outstanding and distinguishing professor in our country, Professor Asundi stated his presentation sharing his own experience through the years. He emphasized the relationship and close interaction between the higher education and libraries by quoting various examples from the ancient time, medieval time, particularly in the Mughal period, where the libraries are flourished and cherished for the benefit of the users. And finally, it was concluded with that the importance of the preservation of documents in tune with the social media and information literacy. Dr. Gopakumar, the university librarian, Goa University, Goa, in his plenary presentation, highlighted the various skills and competencies required for the modern library professional, which includes managerial skill, technology skill, creative skills required for academic librarians to lead in the digital era. There are 15 papers were listed in this first technical session, out of which 8 papers are presented by the respective author. Most of the papers are focused on changing role of academic libraries in higher education to improve the teaching, learning, research and extension activities of the library. The second technical session of the conference, chaired by Dr. Nagappa Bakkananur, the head, the Information Center, Tata Consultancy Services, Bangalore, and Dr. Vijay Raj Kumar, librarian and president of Karnataka State College Library Association, was the reporter for this technical session. Dr. I.R.N. Gowdar, library advisor and visiting professor, Bangalore University Library, Bangalore, delivered the theme paper on technology challenges for digital librarianship in the digital era. He was presented various trend reports brought out by the various international organizations such as IFLA, ALA, OCLC. The outcome of these reports is an eye-opening for the LIS professional to redesign the libraries and information centers in tune with the technological influences. Dr. Gowdar listed out top trends in academic libraries. Finally, he was presented a positive impact of the social media and mobile application in library services. In this technical session, there are 21 papers are listed, out of which 11 papers are presented by the respective author. The enthusiastic authors are presented in various emerging technologies and its positive impact on library functions, activities and services. Technical session 3, the theme of the technical session 3 is information standards in library services. The technical session 3 was chaired by Professor Kaiser Nikam, the professor, the Department of Library and Information Science, University of Mysore. Mrs. Nirupa served as a reporter for this technical session. She worked as a selection grade librarian, Government First Aid College, Chamrajpet, Bangalore. Mr. V.L. Kalyan, the former head and manager, Technical Information Center, BEL, and former librarian of Indian Statistical Institute, Bangalore, is delivered a thematic talk on standards for library and information services. Mr. Kalyan listed out various standards for library activities, functions, including library and information services. And the LIS professional need to take the advantage of the various standards to make assessment of the quality of libraries. Whereas now the assessment is taking place for the quality of colleges through NBA or NAC. Now we need to concentrate on to assess the quality of libraries by taking ISO 9002 standards. That's what he has listed out various standards, which is very useful for the library professional took into consideration. There are 13 papers are listed in the technical session 3, and out of which 7 papers are presented by respective author. Most of the authors stressed about the various standards it is required for the library and information center, including the TQM, Total Quality Management, its application to library and information centers. Technical session 4, that is the second day of the national conference, was begun exactly 10 a.m. with a brief video presentation of Jain University Library, Jainagar campus, which contains the innovative best practices, work culture, teamwork, capacity building among the LIS professional working in this Jainagar center. Really, I was overwhelmed about the video which is presented by in the early morning. We need to take into consideration and we have to put before the users what really we are doing in the library, both inside the library or outside the library. This was really a motivating video for the delegates, which I believe personally. The technical session 4 was chaired by Dr. Mallinath Kumba, the professor, Department of Library and Information Science, University of Mysore. Mrs. H.A. Sumana, selection grade librarian, she was acted as a reporter for this 4th technical session. The 4th technical session, the lead paper, invited paper was delivered by Dr. B. Ravi Gadginbach, an experienced university librarian of Gulbarga University, Gulbarga, on the very interesting and useful topic for the academic professional, that is innovative services and best practices in libraries, the challenges and opportunities. He stressed upon the librarians, in order to involve routine library activities, they should involve and anticipate especially innovative best practices, and he has outlined the various best practices in terms of the collection development, in terms of the services, in terms of the manpower, etc. He concluded that the preventing particularly he has envisioned the futuristic approach of the libraries. That is a need of the hour. We need to think of the how to handle the future libraries and as how to act as a future librarian. In this technical session, 10 papers were listed, out of which 6 papers are presented by respective author. The last technical session of the two-day national conference, that is on information and knowledge management, chaired by Professor Dr. K.G. Jairam Naik, the Associate Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, Bangalore University, Bangalore, and Dr. Ravi Venkat, Deputy Librarian, Tumkur University, Tumkur, was the reporter for this 5th technical session. In this technical session, we have one invited presentation and one plenary presentation. The plenary presentation was presented by Dr. Anand Bhairappa, Global Leader, Knowledge Center, GE, Bangalore. Given a plenary talk on innovation in information world, trends and scenarios. He highlighted the global innovation trends and related into a library and information trends. It was evident from Anand's talk that innovations will change the LIS profession and drive in its right direction. Dr. Rama Patnaik, librarian, Indian Institute of Management, Bangalore, has delivered the invited talk on web discovery tools. And she has listed out various web discovery tools, including Procast and Procast Suman and EBSCO, and both proprietary as well as the open source web discovery tools. And also she has highlighted what are the important features of these web discovery tools to retrieve the information in the library. In this technical session, there are 19 papers were listed, out of which 9 papers are presented by the respective author. The paper presenters shared their professional and personal knowledge with respect to the information and knowledge management. And finally, my personal observation is that some of the technical session is very hot discussion, very interactive and live. And some technical session too silent. And really it is both inside the auditorium and outside the auditorium, people are interacting each other. And above all that, I interacted with many delegates there. In overall, they are extremely happy about this conference, both technically, intellectually, scholarly, and also deliciously. Finally, I take this opportunity to thank Professor A.Y.S. Sundi, his intellectual contribution, and Dr. Krishnamurthy, the conference director, his moral support in preparation of this conference report. I extend my sincere thanks to the authorities of the China University, entire organizing committee team, especially Madam Ms. Meeramani. Now just we are discussing about nowadays ladies are leading and taking a different role while organizing conference in different parts of Karnataka, particularly last month we have attended in Mysore, and before that we had in Mangalore. Now in Bangalore, I don't, in future, most probably the ladies are taking more role while organizing this kind of a national conferences. Thank you, Mirabhi. Now it is exceeding 70%, that's what I'm feeling. I extend my sincere thanks to all the invited papers and plenary speakers, chairperson of the various technical session, reporters for giving a good input for the preparation of this report. Above all, I thank each one of the authors, each one of the paper presenter for your valuable learned input for the discussions and deliberation. I thank you one and all the paper presenter. I request to give an applause to all the paper presenter for their contribution. Above all that, I thank all the delegates. Without your kind support and active participation, the conference will not be more meaningful. Therefore, I thank each one of you for your interactive and greater participation during the technical session. And before I hand over to the director of the conference, whatever we have deliberated and discussed and interacted this last 2-day conference, we have drafted few conference recommendation. It need to be considered by the China University authorities as well as the NAC and NBA and other competitive authorities implementation of these recommendation. Thank you for giving me an opportunity. Thank you one and all.